Hi guys, in this video, I will be posting 15 SQL queries for practice, which I want you guys to solve. I will be posting the answer in the comment section, but I request you guys to solve them without looking at the solution. Let's see how many queries you can solve and how much time you take to solve them. In this video, we will be dealing with two tables, employee and department. Some of the queries are quite easy, while few can be a little tricky. Let's take a quick look at our tables. The first table we have is employees, which has employee ID, name, gender, role or designation, date of joining, department ID, and salary as columns. The second table we have is department, which has department ID and department name as columns. Let's take a quick look at the sample data for employees before we jump to the question. So we have John, a male employee with the employee ID 1, who is working as an associate since 2000. His salary is 3000 bucks and he works for the department ID 1. Remember, this is just the sample data. The table has many more rows. In the first question, you have to list the employee details who have the third highest salary in their respective departments. So from the sample data, we can see that Sean and Leo have the third highest salary in their respective departments. Now please pause the video and write a generic query that will provide the list of all employees who have the third highest salary in their respective departments. Once you have written the query, you can move to the next question. In the next question, we are introducing our second table, which has three rows: IT, operations, and HR. Again, this is just sample data, and actual table will have many more departments. So the queries that you will write should be generic. In the second question, we have to find the department name which has the highest number of employees, and we have to display its employee count along with it. So here, let's say IT has the highest number of employees, so the answer should look like this. In the third question, we have to identify the oldest employee in each department along with their department names. In the fourth question, we need to list those employees who earn more than the average salary in their departments. In the fifth question, we need to list female employees at associate role with name starting from K and ending with E. In the sixth question, we need to identify departments which do not have any employees assigned to them. In the seventh question, we need to identify the employee with the fourth highest salary across the entire organization. In this question, we need to identify employees on associate role in IT department who have been with the organization for more than 10 years, and we have to grant them a 100% bonus on their salary. Now we have added a new column, manager ID, and in the ninth question, we need to identify employees who earn below 3000 and don't have a manager assigned to them. In the 10th question, we need to identify employees from HR department who joined between 2012 and 2016 and report to the manager with employee ID 20. In the 11th question, we need to list the employee name and salary along with the difference of their salary in comparison to the person earning the maximum salary in their department on their role. For example, Since John earns the maximum salary as associate in IT department, his difference is zero. And because Jane earns 1000 less than John, the same should be reflected as the difference. In the 12th question, we need to display the department name along with the count of those employees who earn more than the average employee's salary in the organization. In the 13th question, we need to display the department name along with the employee ID of all the managers working in that department. In the 14th question, we need to display the details of the employees who are the newest employee of their respective departments. And we have to do this without using self-join. In the final question, we need to list all the department names that have at least 10 employees who are working in the organization since last 5 years. Guys, please post your answers in the comment section and I will be uploading more such exercises pretty soon. Thanks a lot guys for watching this video and I will see you in the next one.